everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the dungeon. My name is Robin, and today is Lampworking in Black and White, Volume 28. Today I wanted to show you guys another cane that I think is just super fabulous, the double twisted cane. When I finished this bead and I was looking at it from far away, it kind of reminded me of houndstooth, that beautiful cloth. I just love it when the glass imitates fabric. I think that is so magical. It really looks like houndstooth to me. But as Patrick put it politely, it really is just a double twisted cane. I hope you guys enjoyed this demonstration, and there are a multitude of different types of color combinations you could use with this cane. I hope you're all doing safe and well out there wherever you may be. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time in the dungeon. All right, I'm going to start this cane out with a base of clear, and I am using a 9mm clear rod, so it's a little thicker and it will get me to a larger amount of glass quicker. So when I have a ball hot on the end of the rod, I like to use my marble mold to shape a really nice even shape. And I'm going to just punty up on the bottom, get a little bit of glass on the top hot, and then just cast it off. And what I have left over, I will just roll out a little bit so I have a nice straight sides. And on top of that, I'm using a black by CIM. And this is a messy color, so it is Hades. And a little bit of it cracked off, so I'm just gonna use my tweezers to finish adding that glass. And what I want to do right off the bat is just pinch the very top so the black lines are coming together at the tip. And then I'll heat it up and roll it out a little bit, because what I want to do is add a whole bunch of clear on top of this. But first, I just want to pull a little bit more of the top out. That's really important to have both sides nice and even. Roll it out a little bit more, and now we will go ahead and start adding our clear on top. And I'll start by adding the clear on top of the black and on the side of the black. And then I'll just work my way around, making sure that everything is coated nice and evenly in the clear. Okay, so I'm just going to round that out a little bit more, heat it up, and I'm going to add a little bit more clear on top of this. And you don't have to do the second layer of clear. I probably didn't need to do this step, but I wanted to have a little bit more space in between the black and the white stripes. Okay, now I will go ahead and add the white in the opposite areas of where I had the black, so you can see everything when you're looking at this cane. I'm not too worried about the very top, because I will be taking the top off. So I'm just really working on the sides and adding a layer or two of the white. I just want to make sure that the color lays down evenly. So just add it where you need to. And then from there, I will go ahead and tighten everything up. And then I'm gonna add another round of clear again. And again, I start by coating the color, and then I'll work the sides as well with a little bit more clear in there. I have to say, this cane ended up being a lot bigger than I thought it was going to be. In fact, I almost decided to scrap this whole project because it was just kind of starting to get a little too big for me. So you might want to start out everything much smaller than you see me working on it here. If this amount of glass intimidates you, then just, you know, make it smaller, make everything smaller, thinner and smaller. But if you end up with a big wad of glass like I have, then you would just want to heat the top up and pull that whole tip off so you have a nice even point to attach your first punty to. Okay, I'm just trying to get my punty right there in the center, and then I will take the other side off, and I will kind of round that out a little bit, because I want to do the same thing. I want to take everything, I want to pull everything out. And as I'm pulling out, I know, you know, you want to see the black and the white cane coming towards that pull. So it's, again, nice and even. And then from here, it's just a lot and lot of heat. A lot of heat. You know, when you have clear, it tends to heat up a little slower, for me at least, than if it was a solid color. So I spend many, many minutes heating this up. And before I start my twists, my long twist, I twist it real tight, and then I just twist, come out of that flame. You're twisting and twisting, and the white will develop as it cools down. So you'll see that beautiful double twist that we have here, and that is our cane. All right, now that we have that massive cane finished, I got plenty out of it, and I will use it all. I'm gonna make the bead just out of clear. You can do any color that you would like for a background. You'll definitely see it through the cane, but this one, I just wanted to showcase the cane itself. So I'm gonna add a whole bunch of clear on here and roll it out so I have kind of like my base bead. And then from there, I will add a big wrap of clear on top of that. And then I will add another wrap of clear. And just like with the cane, sometimes I just get involved in adding the glass and don't really think about how big it's gonna be in the end. But as you will see, this bead ended up being really, really humongous, a lot bigger than I thought it was gonna be. So just like with the cane, if you want a smaller bead and working really big is slightly intimidating to you, just start out really small, maybe with just one large wrap of clear, and then we're going to put the cane on. So I am just starting on one edge of the bead and trying to be as tight as possible when I add this cane. I want it to just about touch the other cane where I lay it down. And if you run out of cane, no problem. Just grab the next piece of cane and kind of overlap the previous cane and then finish your roll. Okay, here it is. It's big, it's massive, it's huge, and it's gonna get bigger. So at this point, after realizing, wow, this is a humongous bead, I just decided to go with the flow and be patient. I did have to cut a lot of this out. I probably spent about 35 to 40 minutes on this bead. But as you can see, all I'm doing is just simply trying to smooth everything out with the graphite paddle. And once that all looks really nice and smooth, I will go ahead and start to encase everything in clear. So I start from the top, work my way down to the bottom, and I overlap on every single swipe. You can already see the cane underneath kind of popping out. It really looks cool. I love encasing glass. I just love the way it raises up everything and gives it that three-dimensional look that I am hoping to achieve. I do add a little bit of clear on the thin end of the clear, and that should help me to even out the whole encasement. And then there's just a lot of heating, and more smoothing, and more smoothing, and more heating, just to get to the final shape. Okay, now that we have gotten there, I'm going to finish everything up by adding some slightly large dots. I'm just adding them four up in the equator area, and then I will go ahead and add a couple, four to the bottom, in the opposite areas, and four to the top or the bottom, whichever way you want to put it. Okay, now that I have all these dots added, and I love to add these clear dots because they really give an interesting effect to the cane underneath. And once everything is nice and soft and about melted down about to where everything looks like a half around, I will go ahead and add another dot of clear just in the middle. I decided I'd just do the middle because sometimes, you know, when you have a lot of glass on the mandrel, it can become very heavy. And that's another reason why I like to work in the middle. Okay, I'm just going to round this out and we are done. I hope you guys enjoy this bead. It is fabulous. And on that note, we'll see you next time in the dungeon.